And we are starting the main part of our consideration, linear transformations, or linear maps. It doesn't write anymore. Linear maps, or transformations, or functions. We have considered the general properties of transformations or maps. So in case we want to consider linear maps, we define them not just on arbitrary sets, but on vector spaces. So let there be vector space V, and then to every vector V of this space, we associate with this vector some vector u from some other vector space, or the same vector space u. V and u may be the same or different. By means of some transformation t, we will call transformations all these functions f, g, all the way a, b, c, and so on. Then we say this transformation is linear if it preserves the linearity condition. So the definition will be the following. A map T from vector space V into vector space U is called linear if for any vectors vectors A, B from V and numbers or scalars alpha, beta from the field F, vector spaces V and U are the field F. Usually as F we know, we assume the real space or the complex, the space of real numbers or the space of complex numbers. If for any vectors A, B from the space V and for any numbers of this field, T of A plus B is T of A plus T of B, the first linearity condition for the addition, and the second T of alpha A equals alpha T of A. This is condition number two. One can show that these two conditions, one and two, together, 1 and 2 together are equivalent to conditions that linear transformation preserves linear combination of any two vectors. That T of alpha A plus beta B equals alpha T of A plus beta T of B. It's easy to show, I leave it as an exercise for students to show this. So, we have already considered some examples of linear transformations from arithmetic space Rn into arithmetic space Rm. As always in transformations, we have the same notions of image, pre-image, injective or one-to-one, surjective or onto transformations, and bijective transformations, which are one and one into onto. And if a linear transformation, a linear map T is injective, it's called an isomorphism. Is bijective, I'm sorry, is bijective. So bijective linear map is an isomorphism. We did give the definition of an isomorphism earlier, and it is the same definition, actually formulated in new terms, because we know some properties of general maps. Now let's consider a few examples, then we will proceed. Example number one, zero map, or O map. O map. It's such a map that V acts from V into U, and for any vector of V, such that for any vector of V, O of V will be zero vector in the space U. You understand that we have two vectors U and V, right? And zero vector in the space U is different from zero vector in the space V, because in general this may be different spaces. Is it really linear? I think it is, because if you consider O of alpha A plus beta B, it will be zero, right? Because zero in space U, and therefore we can view it as alpha times zero in space U plus beta times zero in space U. So we can see it as alpha T, as alpha zero transformation of A, because A, B, any vector will be transformed to zero. So this zero is the image of A plus beta O of V. So the condition 3 holds, and therefore it is linear, because this turns out to be equal to this. That's all we need for linearity. Example number 2, the identity transformation. I will write subscript V, where V is domain of our transformation, yes? V is the domain of our transformation. V is the domain, so it is identity transformation acting on space V. Is it linear? Yeah. Is it linear? It's always a question we will ask. I think it is. Let's check. Identity transformation of vector alpha A plus B beta v will be by definition what is identity? Vector, when it acts on a vector, it's we are getting the same vector. So it will be vector alpha a plus beta b. And a I can replace with the image of a under identity transformation, so it will be alpha identity transformation acting on vector a plus beta identity transformation acting on vector b. So indeed this is an identity transformation, this is a real transformation, because this turns out to be equal to this. It's condition 3, which is equivalent to post-linearity conditions, right? More examples. Example number 3. Differentiation operator. Space of polynomial of degree not exceeding n into the space of polynomial of degree not exceeding n minus 1. Right? How this operator acts? That d applied to a0 plus a1t plus and so on plus a n minus 1 t n minus 1 plus a n t n. When we apply differentiation to such an operator, we are getting a vector a 1 plus 2 a 2 t plus and so on plus the most recent term will be n n a n t to the power n minus 1. So this operator creates polynomials of degree not exceeding n minus 1 out of polynomials of degree n. Why this transformation is linear? You can just check it yourself, because the differentiation operator is linear, right? You know the properties of derivative, right? Derivative of alpha f plus beta g for any functions, not only for polynomials, will be alpha derivative of f plus beta derivative of g. And that's why, of course, it will be true for polynomials as well. Example number 4. Example number 4. A map t assigning acting from the space of matrices of size n by n, m and n, yes, the space of matrices, square matrix of size n by n, into the space of real numbers, into the real axis, defined by the equality for every matrix T of matrix A. Yes, A is n by n matrix equals determinant A. That's a map, right? It acts from vector space of square matrices of size n by n into the real space, which is isomorphic to position vectors along a single line through the origin, right? Is it linear? This transformation T is not linear. Why is it not linear? Because T a plus b, for instance, sense is determinant of matrices A plus B is not equal to determinant A plus determinant B, which would be T of A plus T of B. So linearity is violated. How do I know it is not equal? I think one example would be enough. I can propose an example. For instance, if I take matrices A, B from the space M 2 by 2 matrices, I will say A equals 1, 0, 0, 1, B equals negative 1, 0, 0, negative 1, then determinant, let's say, T of A plus B will be determinant of A plus B, will be determinant when I add these two matrices, 0, 0, 0, 0, it is 0. And T of A plus T of B will be determinant A plus determinant B. This determinant is 1, this determinant is 1. Will be equal to 2. And 0 is not equal to, so the linearity condition does not work. The linearity condition does not work. So this transformation is not linear. I can make a linear transformation from this space into the space of real numbers. Let's have one more example. So example number 5. Transformation. A map. Let's give a different name. It's always T, T. A map G. Mapping the space of matrices n by n into the line of real numbers defined by G of A equals trace of A. This transformation is linear. Okay. Really, if I take, for instance, the first operation, trace of G of A plus B will be trace of A plus B. So it will be, suppose A has entries A11 and so on, B has entries B11 and so on. So it will be A11 plus B11 plus A22 plus B22 plus and so on plus ANN plus BNN, which is equal. Which is equal to A11, I will just regroup these terms, plus A22, plus and so on, plus ANN, plus B11, plus B22, plus and so on, plus BNN. So this is trace of A, this is trace of B. So it will be trace of A plus trace of B. So it will be G of A plus G of B. And similarly, you can verify by yourself that G of alpha A will be alpha G of A, just by writing explicitly the expression for the trace. Yes? When we multiply a matrix by a number, each element of this matrix is multiplied by this number. Therefore, each entry on the diagonal will be multiplied by this number, factor it out and show it. As an exercise, show it yourself. So we have considered a few examples of linear and non-linear transformations. Linear transformations do have some general properties in addition to general properties of maps or transformations in general. There is something specific for linear transformation because they are defined on vector spaces, yes? Not every set is a vector space. General maps may be defined on finite sets and sets, discrete, so-called discrete sets and so on. But here we have vector spaces or spaces in which linear operations are defined. So the some properties of linear maps. Property number one. Whenever linear map is applied to zero vector, it will produce a zero vector. So, in all the statements below, in the statements below, the maps we consider are so T of zero is always zero. We should keep in mind though that we are acting from space V into in general some other space U. So this is vector V. This is vector U. Zero that sits here is zero of space U. Zero vector that sits here is zero vector in space U. This is zero vector in space V. This is zero vector in space U. Yeah? For instance, if you have V if this is operator, for instance, of differentiation, yes, as we have seen, so this vector is a polynomial which consists of a set of n plus 1 zeros, because a polynomial of degree n may have maximum n plus 1 entries, n plus 1 terms that are being added, yes? And this will have only n zeros. Yeah? If it's operation from R3 into R5, this will be column of 3 zeros. This will be column of 5 zeros. So there are different objects altogether. So I should write here 0 from V. How to prove this? I say that T of 0 in space V can be viewed as T of zero number multiplied by some vector V, so it will be zero T of vector V, no matter what is image of vector V, it will be zero vector in space U. Property number two, T of the vector opposite to vector V will be opposite vector of the image of vector A. Prove it yourself. Prove similarly to the above statement. Because the easiest way to prove is to assume that vector V is the hint for the proof is vector V, negative V. Negative V can be seen as negative 1 multiplied by vector V. Or prove by definition of the opposite vector. You can prove by definition that two vectors are opposite of each other if their sum is zero. Property number 3. A linear transformation preserves linear combinations. So if you have a certain linear, it is actually already sitting in the definition of linear transformations if you assume formula number 3, which is equivalent to 1 and 2. Yes? So T, okay, a linear map T preserves linear combinations. What I mean is I have T of x1a 1 plus x2a 2 plus and so on plus xka k. It will be, you can just apply the formula for linearity a few times, and it will be x1t of a1 plus and so on plus xkt of ak. And this is t of a1, t of ak and so on. These are vectors. These are vectors that are images of vectors A. So it will be x1, let's say b1 plus and so on plus xk bk, where b number I is the image of A number I for any I from 1 to k. So it is the same linear combination, yes, it has the same coefficient. So preserves linear combinations. Property number 4, which is important of us, linear map T preserves dependence or independence of a given set. So suppose we have a certain set A1 and so on AK. When we write the condition for linear dependence or independence, we write what? We write x1 a1 plus x2 a2 plus and so on plus xk ak is equal to 0. And then when we apply to both sides of this equality linear transformation, this is zero in space view, of course, yes. When we apply transformation T, which is linear, we will get respectively, if I keep the same notation, x1 v1 plus x2 v2 plus and so on plus xk bk is equal to zero in the space U. So, if there are, I will call this formula 4, and this is formula 5. If sum xi is different from 0 in formula 4, it will be different from 0 in formula 5. If all of these x's are necessarily 0, they will be all necessarily 0. So a linear map transforms linearly dependent set of vectors into a linearly dependent set of vectors, and linearly independent set of vectors into a set of linearly independent set of vectors. Linearly independent set of vectors. I think it would be relevant to say here that I think we did with our former definition of isomorphism, we did put this theorem, I will just repeat it again. We can call it property number 5 or whatever. Vector spaces. So if first part, if dimension of V equals to dimension of U equals sum n, let the sets E1 and so on, En, be a basis in V, and a set F1, Fn, be a basis in U. They consist of the same number of vectors. Then we can require that any vector x from V, there exists a linear combination, there exists a unique linear combination such that vector x is x1 e1 plus and so on plus xn en. Let T map vector x defined by equality, I think it will be 6. Let T maps x defined by 6 into vector y equals x1 f1 plus and so on plus xn fn. This correspondence is an isomorphism because the set, since the set x1 xn is unique for x, also because it's an expansion in a basis. This is an isomorphism for every vector. We have exactly one vector, and we have constructed this vector. And of course, this vector is a member of the space U, because it's just some vector expanded in the basis of F. The other way around. If by definition of the dimension if any set if V is isomorphic to U, which means there exists a linear map, there exists an injective linear map T transforming V into U, then the maximum number of vectors in a linearly independent set V1 Vn must be the same in V and U. In U it will be a set T of V1 and so on, T of Vn. Right? If we suggest that in U there exists n plus 1 or more linearly independent vectors, then we just perform transformation and we will have the result that we need to have a linearly independent set with the same number of vectors, which is greater than n, in V as well, which is impossible. So, if two spaces are isomorphic, they don't have the same dimension. Let's go further. We can consider also operation of composition of linear maps. So I will say it was property 5. Okay, let me. Property 6. A composition of linear maps is a linear map. It is important for us, so we can consider composition, we can introduce the notion of an inverse map in the future and so on. So we have to prove it. Do we have such a property? A composition of linear maps is a linear map. Let T mapping V into U and N transformation S mapping V into U be linear, sorry, and S mapping U into W be linear. We define as usual T is such a transformation as for T applied to vector V will be S of T of V. This will be our definition. Then S circle T applied to vectors A plus B. Will be S of T of A plus B will be S of T of A plus T of B due to linearity of T. Yes, linearity of T. This equality holds thanks to linearity of T, and then thanks to linearity of S, it will be S of T of A plus S of T of B, which is S circle T applied to A plus S circle T applied to B, which proves that the first condition of linearity holds. Similarly, one can prove that S do it yourself circle T of alpha A equals alpha S circle T of A. So both conditions of linearity hold, and therefore the composition of linear maps of transformations is a linear map or a transformation.